Hey, what's going on, folks? Welcome back to The Real Legend of Gaming. We are back with some more Clash Royale. And folks, it is an exciting day. The 20-win challenge for CRL is officially back. And this is your opportunity to earn a chance to be in the Clash Royale League, to play professional esports competitions for the favorite game that we all enjoy. Now, folks, what I will be sharing with you today are five decks that have already been used to complete the challenge. And if anything, these are the top five decks that have been used multiple times. So we're going to give you the decks in the order of the highest amount of victories in the challenge to the lowest, right? But man, they're all pretty good. So don't think that one is better than the other. It all depends on your favorite playstyle. And I think we covered all archetypes in this list here for the most part. So this should be something for everybody who watches the video. Now, enough with all that, folks. Let's get into the decks. And I'm also going to break down ideal ways to use them, counters to the cards, just in case some of you viewers might not be familiar to a certain style. All right, so let's get into it. All right, so the first deck consists of the Archers. Skeletons, Ice Spirits, Ice Golem, Tesla, X-Bow, Fireball, and a Log. This is the famous 2.9 X-Bow deck, and this is a very solid deck because, for one, it has a recently buffed X-Bow, and the Tesla does an incredible job of defending that X-Bow. Now, the ideal way to use this deck is, for one, you don't want to overextend, and you want to be able to protect your expo, but you also don't want to incorrectly drop that expo as well. So ideally what you want to do is make sure that you have a push where, one, you know for sure that the opponent has their heavy spell out of rotation, and two, you want to be able to set this push up the right way. So you set it up with the Ice Golem behind the King Tower, you let it progress past the first Archer Tower, then you want to play your Archers. That way you have some support from a range, since the Archers can cover a couple tiles. Once those troops start approaching closer to the bridge, you want to drop down your Tesla, because that's going to be your main defense for your X-Bow. And then the minute you can have an opportunity, you want to drop your X-Bow a few tiles away from the bridge so that it can still lock on to the opposing tower that you want to target. Use the Ice Spirit and your Skeleton to buy you more time to cycle back to your defense units. It's also going to help you kite away the attention from your opponent's defense. Use the Fireball and the Log as more measures to defend, and also as spells that you can do damage against the tower with to be able to cycle back to your other units. Protect your expo at all times, and you should be A-okay. This deck is really good, but it does require a higher amount of skill. So definitely practice with this deck inside of Classic Challenge matches, since they're cheap, right? 10 gems to get in. Practice with those until you get a good feel and you start winning, you know, 3-4 matches in a row with it. Then jump into the CRL Challenge. So that's the first deck. And also, folks, I am no way a pro expo player. So if you have better tips than mine, drop them in the comment section. They will help everybody out. And that goes for every other deck that I'm going to explain as well. Because on this channel, we make guides for average players, semi-pros, and pros. So if it doesn't work for you, something else will. And if you're a better player than myself, you're going to have a great time with it, right? Next deck. You guys have seen this a lot because it's been one of the most popular meta decks. This is the Baby Dragon, Royal Giant, Guards, Mega Minion, Electro Wizard, Furnace, Lightning, and the Barbarian Barrel. This deck is a powerhouse, right? Ideally, that Furnace is going to be the building that's going to protect your Royal Giant. You want to drop your Royal Giant behind the King Tower as well. Kind of similar strategy for a lot of the tank decks. But only play your Royal Giant when the counter's out the way. And this is probably applicable to every strategy, folks. But make sure that when the opponent plays a Mini P.E.K.K.A. or a P.E.K.K.A. or a Knight or a Mega Minion or even Guards, right? You want to make sure that you get them out of the way first so that you can successfully drop down your Royal Giant. I also forgot to mention Barbarians. That's another card that can cause havoc and the Skarmie. Once those are out of the way, you play your Royal Giant and you support it. Support it with the Baby Dragon. That is my favorite way to do it, because the Baby Dragon splash damage will counter most of the cards that I mentioned earlier. Then use your Mega Minion to help out as well. So as long as you have your Furnace, Baby Dragon, and Royal Giant push going, you should be A-okay. Now, if the opponent stacks up multiple troops, then remember, three units can be taken out with the lightning spell, drop it down on them, and do massive damage. And in whatever you couldn't finish off, you can use the guards, the Mega Minion, the Barbarian Barrel, and E-Wiz to help out. E-Wiz is going to help you against the Infernal Towers and the Infernal Dragons. So also remember that the E-Wiz primarily is there to help you defend against those units. All right. So that's that deck. And again, if I forgot some tips, please forgive me. I'm trying to cover a lot in this video so that you guys have enough information to go into the challenge. And also, I don't bore you guys to death with a very long video. Third deck here. This deck here actually has the highest win rate in the 20 win challenge. It consists of the Barbarians, the Skarmy, the Baby Dragon, the Lava Hound, the Bats, the Flying Machine, the Clone, and the Snowball. Very featured before with the Lumberjack, but this one here is even more OP because it has the Barbarians. And once you clone any of these units here, you're gonna have a swarm, and it's gonna make it very difficult for your opponent to counter. Ideal way to play this, again, once you for sure know that you got your counters out for the Lava Hound, drop it behind the tower, let it progress a little bit. The Lava Hound is a little faster than the Golem, so if you are a Golem player looking to switch over to Lava Hound, be prepared to drop your second unit a little bit sooner. Ideally, you could place the Baby Dragon behind it and the Flying Machine, or you could do the Baby Dragon with the Bats, but the main purpose for the Bats, Barbarians, and the Skarmy is to help you defend against the units that are down below. And obviously the Bats will help you defend against the units above, but they're usually going to get destroyed fairly quick because most of the flying units do very good range damage and splash damage. So the Flying Machine is going to be very crucial in this deck because it just sits back and does attacks. And it really doesn't get the focus attention from the opponent yet because they're going to be focused on the Baby Dragon or the Lava Hound. And then you're going to use your Snowball to knock back troops and also buy some more time to cycle back to something else. So once you have your Lava Hound roaming, you throw down that Baby Dragon or the Flying Machine or the Bats, you support with the Barbarians, Bats, or Skarmy, and if all that, you know, is across the bridge, you can drop down your clone spell and create havoc for your opponent, because now the Lava Hound is going to be tanking for spawns of an entire group. And it's going to be very difficult unless they have a fireball in there to throw and mitigate the damage, or if they have a zap spell, it's going to really be a pain for them, and you're going to take their tower down and most likely push your way to a three crown as well. Very solid deck. Fourth is, you know, we got to have a P.E.K.K.A. deck, and I actually featured this on the channel as well. This is a P.E.K.K.A. Ram Rider deck. Really good deck. I personally like to use this deck a lot. Has the Baby Dragon, the Electro Wizard, the Bandit, the Ram Rider, Poison, Barbarian Barrel, and Snowball. The way to play this deck, P.E.K.K.A. is your main tank, right? Don't reveal that P.E.K.K.A. unless you really need to, because it is one of those surprise cards that can really destroy your opponent's push, because one, it could defend against so many strong, powerful ground units. It can wreck the Golems. It can wreck the Mega Knight. It can destroy the Hogs. It can destroy the Elite Barbarians. Even though I don't think I'll see many of them in the challenge, it can definitely destroy the Royal Giant. It can destroy the Giant. The P.E.K.K.A. is a beast. You want to support the P.E.K.K.A. with the Baby Dragon or the Electro Wizard, right? Use that Electro Wizard if you know for sure they got an Inferno Tower or Inferno Dragon. I keep saying that, but it's most important value for the E-Wiz. Then the Bandit, you're going to be able to use against any units that happen to sneak in. Or you can use it behind the P.E.K.K.A. and do some classic bridge spam, right? The Ram Rider, even though the Ram Rider is sufficient on his own during single elixir time, you can use the Ram Rider to support the P.E.K.K.A. as well, because that lasso is going to help stun units, and it's only going to buy your P.E.K.K.A. more time to swing its sword. So again, folks, very solid deck, and you add in the poison spell is just ideal because it's going to do damage to those units attacking your P.E.K.K.A., and it's going to get rid of those annoying spawner troops that can kite away the P.E.K.K.A. or do damage, right? So that's that deck. Now we're going to go into the fifth deck, the last one. And this is a Golem deck, right? I got you guys. I got the Golem beatdown players. You know how to get a video with a deck in there, right? Golem, Baby Dragon. And can I take a moment to give love to the Baby Dragon? Baby Dragon is almost in every deck. I'm telling you, my favorite epic card, favorite card in the game probably. About time to get some respect. Baby Dragon, paired up with the Prince, the Guards, the Mega Minions, the Lightning, the Slowbowl, the Barbarian Barrel. My goodness, is a crazy deck. And this was actually, if I'm not mistaken, was the first deck to win the CRL Challenge. So it is a good one. Where you play this, right? Just like I said with everything else, wait for you secure the counters, right? Then you want to play your Golem. And you want to play pair it up with either the Baby Dragon or the Mega Minion, right? One air unit. Then your third unit is going to be either the Guards or the Prince. So you got to play the Golem with one air and one ground unit. Very, very important, because you want to be able to defend against everything to make sure it does not break down your Golem. Then after that, because all the other units are fairly cheap, you can cycle back and support. Use the Lightning spell to clear the path as well. Yes, it's an expensive spell, but it will definitely make life easier for your Golem. And once you have a strong Golem push, not a lot is going to stop it. And it's going to give you a very easy tower for your score. And if it's strong enough, it will get you that 3-crown win. Now, the decks that you need to watch out for are the P.E.K.K.A. decks. There's going to be a lot of them. Decks that, if you see them, you should feel pretty good about is if you see an Expo deck, you can easily use the Golem to stop that from targeting on the tower. And since most of the units are fairly, they don't really do a lot of damage, right? Because the most damage in that deck is the Expo. You're going to be okay, right? Because the Baby Dragon will be able to counter against the Archers. The Prince will be able to target some of the units as well. And then you also got the Lightning. So if they were to stack up a Mega Minion and two Archers, you could do damage with that. You do lose one Elixir, but in an emergency situation, you got to do what you got to do, right? But folks, that's it. Those are the best five decks for the CRL Challenge. I wish everyone luck. If you get the 20 wins and you watch my video and one of these decks help you, then let me know in the comment section. I want to shout you guys out in my next video, and I definitely want to celebrate this with you guys, all right? So other than that, appreciate all the support. Again, good luck, folks. Peace.